Clearly, I mean, we are doing it at very low level at the present time. So I have started to get a computer biologist in my lab already. But clearly, you know, having even more of it, that will be very interesting and very important, I think. This is really an area I push my PhD student always to go into bioinformatics and start it to look at big data analysis, because that's, I think, the future. And I think without that, and also mathematical modeling, so we are at present time in discussing a few collaboration with mathematicians to see whether we can, you know, by mathematical modeling, understand the niche interaction with the different, and maybe make some hypotheses of you know, by mathematical modeling, and see whether this is true and in our system. There's clearly a number of things that we could think of course, when we look at the cells and their movement, because we can track these in vivo in a live mice, so we can also see not only, you know, where they go, but physically where they interact, whether they stay in the same environment, whether they are motile, and these will give us a better clue of, you know, the real niche, because everybody is talking about hematopoietic stem cell niche or leukemic stem cell niche, but physically, you know, is there one niche, three niche, or how long these stem cells stay in contact with their same environment? We clearly see by injecting normal stem cell, actually, that they may be much more motile than we think. And the question is, there seems to be talking to the environment by, you know, spending a bit of extension of their cells. Usually a stem cell is very small, roundish, but we saw in vivo that they are not. They form filopodia and discuss with different neighbors and go back to where they were and change direction. So clearly, all that is new for us, and we still don't know what that means, but I'm sure it has importance. So even stopping these cells for whatever reason, by whatever mechanism we find, you know, is there going to be differences? If they don't move, what will be the consequence? And that's something that we would like to know. And there's so many things that we will be interested in, you know. It's quite clear in MDS specifically that there's probably an inflammatory, chronic inflammation that is a part of the disease. And we don't know anything about, you know, even in a normal HSC situation, in case of inflammation response, what happens to the cells, how they react, you know. So is opening a new door for us, I think, that is going to be giving us some work for a few years to go, I suppose.